yourself. Be straight. Forget your ministry. Think of yourself. Get restored to God. The ministry will take care of itself. This is what the Lord told me. Ministry, testimony, we talk about that. No, no, no. Yourself. Be straight. David, the man who served his own generation, he was conscious of the deceit that has come in, and he wanted God to deal with it. That's it, friends. It's not enough just to say, oh God, I have fallen, I have gone away, please forgive me. So God should pat me on the back and take me in. No, no, no. There should be a thorough overhauling. So what was his request? What was his request? His request was not for deliverance from the consequences of sin. Most of us are bothered about it. People talk about me. I have brought shame on me. So restore me. So we won't put it that way. We'll say my ministry. Forget your ministry. Think of yourself. Get restored to God. The ministry will take care of itself. This is what the Lord told me. Ministry, testimony, we talk about that. No, no, no. Yourself, be straight. So what was his request? Not deliverance from consequences. See the difference from Saul. Saul said to Samuel, I have sinned, yes, yes, I have sinned, but please honor me before the people. Come with me to worship the Lord so they don't think anything. That's what he was interested in, what people will think of him. Some of us are more concerned about what people will say about us and think of us than what God will think of us. But one day, it will really matter what God thinks of you, not what people think of you. You know that? So his request was not for deliverance from consequences. God will take care of the consequences. Your ministry, your testimony, your family, God will take care of that. You take care of yourself and your relationship with Him. So what did he ask for? Two things. He talks about the heart and he talks about the spirit. What does he say about the heart? Verse 10, Psalm 51, verse 10, create in me a pure heart. A clean heart, a pure heart. Oh, that is what I want, Lord. I don't want to go back to this sin. I have backslidden with my friends, with my company, and with what I've been doing, my lifestyle, my habits. I don't want to go back to that. Give me a clean heart. That's what he wanted. Then verse 6, we saw that already. Behold, you desire truth in inner parts. A truthful heart, no more deceit. Inside and outside the same. Before God, a truthful heart. Lord, I want to be truthful before you. Whatever people may say or think before you, I want to be truthful. Then a wise heart in that same verse 6. God desires truth. And then wisdom in the inmost place. What is wisdom? The fear of God. Fear of God is a wisdom. So he was saying, Lord, put fear of God in me so I won't go near sin anymore. I'll be so filled with the fear of God that I'll refuse to touch anything wrong. So fill me with truthfulness and with the fear of God. Then the second word I said is the word spirit. Verse 10, create in me a pure heart. Renew a steadfast spirit. A steadfast spirit. Not an unstable spirit, not a swaying spirit, but a firm spirit, steadfast spirit. Then verse 11, the Holy Spirit, the spirit of holiness. Then verse 12, the willing spirit. What is that willing spirit? Willing to obey. A spirit of willingness to obey. So it matters, doesn't it? What we pray for after we backslide. What do we want? What do we want? Our relationship with the Lord to be what it should be. Everything else will take care of itself. So, how about us? Has there been a word from the Lord? What is His word to you? Let us spend time in quiet prayer, opening our hearts before the Lord, things that are known to Him and to no one else, and to us also. Open it up and confess it to Him. Seek His forgiveness and cleansing. Then ask for restoration, the relationship with Him, the heart and the spirit, referring to the inner man, both of this, heart and spirit, a broken and a contrite heart. You will not despise, my Lord, my God. You heard us now. As we prayed, as we sang, as we sat in your presence with our entire lives open before you, I pray that your mercy, your grace will flow through us, cleansing us, changing us, that as we leave the Bible study this evening, we will be changed people, new people, people with hope. Not just talking about our failure or others' failure, but talking about the grace and the hope that come from you. So send us. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God our Father and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all now and forevermore. Amen.